In this example, we are given that in the figure, the length of incline is 2√3 meter and a block is projected up the incline at a speed of 10 meters per second. We are required to find the speed with which the block will move off the top of the incline. Now, if we just realize the situation practically, we can see this block is projected up the plane with an initial speed V1, which is given to be 10 meters per second. And we are also given that the friction coefficient between the incline and the block is 1/√3, because of which the block will be retarded, and when it will reach the top of the incline, say for example its speed becomes V2, with which it will move off the inclined plane. So here we are required to find this speed V2. In this situation, from the initial position say A to the final position B, we can directly use work energy equation. In this situation, let us use work energy equation from A to B. We can see initial kinetic energy of the block was 1/2 mv1 square. We can see when it is going up, it was experiencing an opposing force due to a component of its weight, that will be mg sin 60 degree. Along with this, it will also experience friction in the direction opposite to its motion, and it will be μmg cos 60 degree, because here we can say the normal reaction acting on the block will be mg cos 60. So friction during motion will be μmg cos 60. Here we consider this mu is the coefficient of kinetic friction. So both of these forces will be doing negative work on the block during its motion for the total displacement length L. So we can write initial kinetic energy minus, it will be mg sin 60 degree into L minus μmg cos 60 degree into L. This is equals to the final kinetic energy of the block, that is 1/2 mv2 square. This is the final kinetic energy at the top of the incline. So we are here required to find the value of this speed V2. We just substitute the values here. Before that, you can see the values of m will get cancelled out throughout the equation. If we put the value of V1 as 10 meters per second, you see we'll be getting 10 square divided by 2. Minus g we can take at 10, sin 60 is √3/2, and the length of incline is 2√3 meter, minus mu we can take, it is given as √1/√3, multiplied by g we can take 10, cos 60 will be 1/2, and length of incline is 2√3 is equals to 1/2 of v2 square. From here, easily we can get the value of V2. If we just simplify this, you can see this 2 gets cancelled out, 2√3 also gets cancelled out. Here we'll be having 100/2, this is 50. This √3 into √3, 3 into 10, it is minus 30. Now here we'll be having only 10 is equals to 1/2 into V2 square. We just simplify this, you can see 50 minus 40, it is 10 into 2, it will be 20. So this gives us V2 is equals to √20 meters per second, that is the speed with which the body will move off the inclined plane at the top. So this will be the answer to our problem.